And next kind of we'll be introducing Osoto Gari. That's why I was really clear about Sototochi and Osoto Gari. These are two different techniques. They look the same, but totally different. The pattern of the movement look the same, but the finish and the way the leg work is totally different. We're going to do three throws that you can see how look like Osoto Gari against opposite side, right? When people do choke throws, okay? I'm in that position, right? If you hear, usually when you scoop around, people standing up with this leg, that's a perfect scenario you want to do here. You want to do Osoto Gari. I'm in the same position, right? I go here, the step, we're going to do Osoto Gari. One more time. I'm in that position, right? I go super around, this time in front of this leg, we do Osoto Gari. Okay. The difference here is this. When people do shoulder throw, right? And you skate, usually they want to standing up with this leg. That leg's already up and set up. This one is to hook, right, and go to do Osoto Gari. Right? That's a difference between Sototochi, the two knees remaining on the floor, Osoto Gari, one knee goes up. You step and you hook the leg, okay? Even it's more usually, you can do it either way, versus right, versus same side, versus opposite side. I do prefer doing more, right, against opposite. Right, here, they try to stand up with this leg. I go here, I'm going to do also the back. Okay, I'm going to do triple throw, that you can see it, now we're fighting. Right, I have super arm, the step. Also the back. Okay, in that position. Go, ah, super arm, step. Also the back. Okay, that's one. Go, here, step, and okay, that's it. Osoto Gari against shoulder throws. How you using when people do even same side, opposite side, you can use Osoto Gari against shoulder throws. It's a really good counter. Remember, every counter is in base of the defense that you're going to do. That's really important to understand.